Hello, I'm Martinez. I'm making this action co-op game where the player has to assemble the conveyor and ship the goods out of the factory. Well, let's begin devlog number 4. In this video, I'll be showing how I made a crane. It may get a bit more technical than the previous parts. Okay, so why I'm creating the crane in the first place? I thought that the crane will reach up the gameplay, and so it did. I'm going to break down this video into different steps: modeling the crane, animating the player, coding the crane mechanics. Before we start doing stuff, it would be great if you visit my game's Steam page and add it to your wishlist. It would help a lot. Thanks. Okay, so let's start with modeling the crane. I won't get too technical in this part. Actually, I believe I deleted the footage where I was modeling the crane, so this is me modeling the rails for the crane. Why I'm adding the rails anyway? When I made a crane, it was static and stuck in one place. This really adds a constraint for level design. And then I thought it would be great if a player would be able to push the crane around on rails. And I'm sorry I don't have footage for the crane modeling. Actually, it's a very simple model made from very basic shapes. On the bottom of a crane, I added little wheels for a crane to drive through the rails. And then I colored everything with the same method as I shown in the earlier devlog series. And also added a second UV channel to bake the ambient occlusion. And there we have it, the crane model. Now, when I imported the crane into Unity, I need to set up the basic animations for a player. The player has to climb up and climb down, and I'll add some motion when he moves around. Okay, so the climb up and climb down animations are pretty simple. I animated them by hand. One thing I made is an animation event on the last frame of climb down animation. This event tells that the animation is done and changes the player state to idle. Well, now that's done, let's go to the animator window. So, here is the transition to the crane animations. The player sits down, then he enters the crane sitting animation, which is a blend tree module. Inside it, it has three animations. One of them is sitting straight and the other two are leaning to the right and left sides. But why is that? So when I rotate around, the player is leaning towards the direction of a rotation. And the last animation is climbing down, which has a transition to the movement. And that's it for animations. Moving on to coding. So there are two types of cranes. One is static and one is on rails. Well, there is a lot of code here, which is maybe not that fun to watch. I'll try to show you only the key things. The first one is the player interaction with the crane. If there's a player within an interaction distance, I'm waiting for him to click the interaction button. What is the interaction button, you may ask? Well, I wrote the key bindings class with lots of different actions. It takes data from my JSON file, and I find the system easier to use when handling the inputs. And yes, I never tried the new input system package. Okay, so if a player presses the interaction button, I set the player driving reference to make the crane occupied. And also, if the crane type is on rails, the player can also press the edit button, which lets the crane be moved around. Okay, now let's move to the controls of the crane. So I have two primary inputs, horizontal x-axis, which stands for A and D buttons. Also, I have a vertical axis to move the crane pliers up and down. Now that we have the basic movements, we can try to grab the boxes. Oh, and one more thing. I made the hydraulics for the crane with this script. It's actually very simple, they are just looking at each other. I have another script that is responsible for crane pliers. It has a method called plier control, which is responsible for a couple of things. Checking that pliers are not colliding with the wall. Also, it draws this line, so it is easier to see where the box might land up upon a drop. It also has two states. One is closed and the other one is open. Actually, it's pretty simple. If a box touches this plier trigger, it becomes marked for pickup. If a player closes the pliers, the marked box quickly translates to the plier pickup point. And if he opens the pliers, it drops the box by re-enabling the rigid body. So, let's see how it came out in practice. I believe that's a great result. What do you guys think? Maybe you have some other ideas which could work for my game. Leave your thoughts in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next part of this devlog series. Bye!